on them, and we need to continually pray for them and encourage them. So, Jordan, and I think you guys are ready. Thank you. Okay, last but not least, we have a special group, Real Rep, they call themselves, and they're going to present to you a really deep song. And here they are. Check. Check.
Thank you.
leaders. Could you give them a hand in the space? Put it down on the level ground. One more. Let me move. Five more.
I want to have Stevie come back up here. Stevie was his first year going here, and I don't know how much of y'all know about Stevie, but he's a really, really good kid. When he comes from. He came out there and he did a rap solo, but the kid is so anointed that he couldn't write the lyrics down because he had to freestyle it while he was there. He blew everyone away, but because he didn't have the words written down, they didn't let him move through. But he is so anointed that I said it was such a shame. Sorry, I'm gonna get up. I was very angry yesterday. So anyway, but I want you just to hear how anointed this young man is. He's a good kid.
It's been on the beats, but for real, Lord, got much for you. He was touching me so he could talk right to you. He told me, Lord, please go ahead and do your thing. Don't worry about the money, don't worry about me. Don't worry about car, don't wanna be a star. And Lord, I know you taking me so far. I said, Lord, please take down these kids away, because I know that they is something in my way. I guess this path is so hard when it's full of rap. I got something in my mind that is doing its fast. So I feel life is hard when I'm doing it. I feel it's hard when we try to part of the crew. But I ain't never said that I came out of the blue. The Lord is my man, so he knows what to do. So I guess I call him, my name is Stevie, and the people in the church really don't want to believe it, but I feel this is something just straight from the heart. So I told the Lord, I'm gonna go and play my part. And it's hard when you gotta try to read the word, and then you know when the streets hit your mind is disturbed. I done hit the curb, I done hit the road, and I know cause it's hard when my story's told. I feel spoken word just be in my mind. It's whole hard time, life when it's all about time, it's all about rhymes. I guess I'ma do good, girl. I feel like it's okay, but you don't take no pills. Don't be no drugs, don't be no threat. I guess it's hard when your face is in the rough. I guess I had no doubt, but it thanks to my father that one day I could say that I'm proud of my father. So I guess I know that it's hard for me, but it's okay cause the Lord won't take it off me. So let me keep on going, let me keep on flowing. It's time for my feet to keep going. I guess time for my boat to keep on strong, because I know it's hard when my mind is still on frozen. It's on point, man, but it's straight from the joint. And the Lord go ahead, he give me anointings. Right back to the blessings of the time. It's hard when you try to spend two more rhymes. Don't do it two more times, don't cross two more times. I guess it's hard when I ain't writing no lines. This is lyrics from the time that you say is a blessing. But life is so hard when you always stressing. So give up your life and give it to the Lord. He's your faith, he's your source. So come on, man. I guess it's hard when I see you like a star, man. You can see it by my face, I'm getting replaced. It's hard when you gotta look up at the Lord in your chest. Okay.
Come on, give him another hand. Maybe see it, I think. You doing anything else? Anything I don't know about? Take me in the Word to 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 6. Just going to leave that up there for a minute. Let me talk to you. Any of you ever heard of generational curses? Raise your hand if you have. Generational curse. And isn't God good the way He confirms everything we're talking about? Today I want to preach a sermon to you that God has laid on my heart heavy. It's called Reverse the Curse. I hand wrote all my notes, then last night I as well as I could type, 4 hours worth of just 5 pages in 16 DPI. That may mean nothing. It doesn't mean anything. What it means is I'm a bad typist. But I think the message is going to be right. I want you to look at the Word for a moment. It says, now these things occurred as examples to keep us from setting our hearts on evil things as they did. Today we have an opportunity to look at a story. And you'll probably hear it like you've never heard it before if the Holy Spirit takes complete control, which is what I'm trying to do right now. I got my own mind, but I'd rather just hear from the presence of God. Amen?
Amen.
And what I want to share with you is that we think of how to reverse a curse. We think of, you know, if we are believers, then we say, there is therefore now no weapon formed against me that shall prosper. The blood of Jesus breaks all curses. And yet, we seem to be walking in the footsteps of the curses of the generation before us.
Amen.
And something's amiss, something's wrong, something is definitely wrong. And maybe in this scripture, as Paul describes it, he says, you know, these things from Abraham and all these others happened to us as examples that we might know not to turn to evil and not to do that. Don't set your heart. Don't set your heart
on the